see how to isolate the bacteriophages from the sewage sample. So let us know what are these bacteriophages. So what are these bacteriophages means? Simply we can define them as viruses which infect the bacteria. We can define them as viruses which infect the bacteria, or simply we can call them as bacteria eaters. And these were first identified and described by the scientists known as Frederick Claude and Felix D. Herrell in the year 1917. And if you look at the different kinds of the bacteriophages, there are three types. Icosahedral head without tail, and other one icosahedral head with tail, and the other form is filamentous phages. So these are the three different types of phages you can see. And here I have put the diagram of the phage, where you can see it has been divided into a head, which is icosahedral in shape, and the tail along with the tail fibers. So when you look at the head region consists of the nucleic acid. So these nucleic acid, it can be circular or linear or single stranded or double stranded DNA molecule, or it can be linear RNA molecule. Depending upon the phage, the nucleic acid will be varied. And this nucleic acid will be enclosed in a capsid which is made up of protein. So why there is a requirement of the capsid? Because it protects the nucleic acid from host nucleases. Whereas coming to the next part, that is neck, which will connect the head to the tail sheath, and you can see the long tube like structure which is called as a tail sheath, and at the base you can see the base plate which is having the tail fibers. So this is the general structure of the bacteriophage. Now coming to the how does these bacteriophages will infect the bacteria or the host cell. There are two types of infections you can see. When phage infects a host cell, what is a host cell here? Bacteria. So at that time, the phage genome will enter into the host cell. Either it can integrate, the phage genome, either it can integrate it to the host genome. But that type of infection is known as lysogeny. Or it can independently replicate and form the and produce the prophages, which considered as the lytic infection. So there are two types of infection, lysogenic or lytic infection. So here you can see the picture where the phage particle had been adsorbed to the bacterial cell. This is the bacterial cell where it has been attached or adsorbed to the host cell, and you can see the incision of the nucleic acid into the host cell. Either it will integrate into, this is the bacterial genome and this is the viral genome. It has been integrated into the host genome. So this type of infection is lysogeny, or it can independently replicate inside the host cell to produce the progeny or the prophages. These will be released by the lysis of the bacteria. It will kill the bacterial cell and then only it can release the progeny. So roughly, if one phage infects the host cell, about 100 phages will be released from that infected host cell. Okay, so this is just an introduction what is meant by the bacteriophages. Now coming to the procedure. So first of all, we need to we need to prepare the phage suspension and the host cell. So how to prepare the phage suspension? So most probably we will isolate the bacteriophages from the sewage sample. So we need to be ready with the sewage sample, filter it and collect in the sterile test tube for the flux. And before the experiment, one day prior to the experiment, you need to go with the preparation of the host cell or the bacteria. So how to go this one? Whatever the E. coli culture has been there, it has to be inoculated into the LP drawer, about 5 ml, and to that 20% maltose has been added along with 1 molar MgSO4. Roughly 50 microliters will be added to the 5 ml of LP broth which has been inoculated with the E. coli culture. Incubate this culture for 37 degrees centigrade for 24 hours. So by this we will have the host cell or the bacteria culture with us. Now coming to the other preparation, we need to go with the soft agar preparation So soft agar preparation is nothing but where the agar will be added about 0.5 to 0.8%. And the next one is we need to prepare the hard agar also. So generally we know how to prepare the hard agar. Roughly we will be adding 2% of agar. This you need to keep it in mind. Soft agar always you need to add 0.5 to 0.8% of agar. Now all the preparations have been done. How to go with the experiment? So first of all we need to take the hard agar, pour it into the sterile petri plates, let it solidify. Then before during solidification you can go with this preparation where to the soft agar medium. E. coli culture, whatever we had prepared in advance, that E. coli culture will be added to the soft agar along with the seaweed sample. The filtered seaweed sample will be added to the soft agar. So this suspension will be overlaid onto the hard agar. Okay, the soft agar which has been inoculated with E. coli and seaweed sample will be overlaid onto the hard agar. Let it solidify and then incubate at 7 degrees centigrade for 24 to 48 hours. So after that, how do you observe the plants? What is the observation? You can make it out from this experiment. So here, when you look at the plate, you can see the whole plate will be covered with the host cell, that is nothing but the bacterial cell, which is nothing but we took the E. coli over here. So the whole plate will be having the culture of the E. coli. But when you see, keenly if you observe, you can see the clear zones on the surface of the plate, which are nothing but the plants. The clear zones are considered as the plants. So that means the bacteriophages in this specific area, they had been killed the bacterial cell due to the successive infections. So that's why you can see the clear zone at particular areas on the surface of the agar. So these are considered as the plants. And one more important thing, the number of plants equals to the number of phage particles. Please remember, number of plants equals to the number of phage particles. We can count the number of plants and we can roughly say how many phage particles have been present in that seaweed sample. I hope it is clear. Thank you.